Oh my God! If you could see that! Oh my God! It landed! Oh my God! Tornado! Tornado!
Caught in a disaster.
We're in Hempfield, Pennsylvania, March 23rd, 2011. This tornado, we don't get tornadoes here.
Tornado touchdown with devastating results.
I'm fine. Honest, I'm fine. Probably won't come in, probably won't hit me for a couple days yet, but I'm fine.
Now tonight, a plea for action.
They want to declare it a disaster area. Who wouldn't? People all across Westmoreland County sending out a plea to the governor tonight for any and all help he can give. Our team of reporters is in the thick of the damage tonight. Channel 4 Action News reporters Jennifer Mealy and Ashley Hardway. Ashley, you're up first live in Hempfield Township.
Well, good evening to you, Wendy. The tornado touched down between these homes as the damage shows and kept onward, destroying with it memories and the American dream. But the one thing it couldn't take away, the American spirit, which here in Fort Allen tonight is stronger than ever as hope came after the storm.
Honest, I'm fine.
The people of Fosterville Road couldn't believe the horror that came with daylight. Donna Ross had lived here for decades.
By the time I got from the bedroom to the downstairs, it was done. Everything was done.
As she and her family cleaned, Pima surveyed Hempfield Township leaders working on getting her and her neighbors help.
We're hoping that they go back and meet with the governor and let him know the seriousness of what has occurred here, and that really the residents of Hempfield Township, Westmoreland County really do need assistance here.
Ross and her neighbors will be able to go to the township Friday and fill out a form to try and get low interest loans to rebuild their homes, their lives.
And that's the only thing that got knocked over, but there were some collectibles in there. But
with holes, cracks in her walls, the violent winds showed grace on her most prized possessions.
It's a Harley Davidson. This is the Harley Davidson teapot. It was only made one time in 1999.
Dozens of delicate teapots untouched, shedding hope for her that through hurt comes hope. Hope her leaders will help her financially.
I think that would be great. That would help a lot of people here. A lot of people here.
Hope that her neighbors will still be her neighbors.
It'll be okay, though. It'll be okay.
Again, local leaders here are going to petition Governor Corbett to make a disaster declaration to help secure some low interest loans and even secure some funding for these people to help cover what insurance won't. Everyone we spoke with who lives on this block did have homeowners insurance. Reporting live in Westmoreland County tonight, Ashley Hardway, Channel 4 Action News.
Yeah, what a blessing that is, Ashley. Damage so extensive. The Hempfield Area School District canceled classes today. This just in tonight, some schools will open back up tomorrow. The superintendent says tomorrow the only schools that will remain closed are Hempfield High School, Harold Middle, Fort Allen Elementary, and Crossroads Alternative. All other Hempfield area schools will open again tomorrow. Plus, this is big, there is no transportation for Greensburg Catholic High School students. The tornado badly damaged the high school, ripping apart the stadium piece by piece. Perhaps the most frightening part, though, of all, was the people who captured the funnel cloud as it formed. Watch.
Look at the cloud. What the heck? What the f***? That's forming a tornado!
Oh! There's a tornado!
Talk about frightening. Code enforcement crews and engineers inspecting the school today. And imagine this. Kids jumping on a trampoline, jumping up and down, suddenly the tornado picks it up and throws it 5 football fields away. Channel 4 Action News reporter Jennifer Mealy with the children who cannot believe they escaped.
Well, on any other night, you might find children in this neighborhood riding their bikes or even jumping on the trampoline. But tonight, many of the families are gone, forced to stay with relatives because their homes are boarded up.
We were jumping on the trampoline with my sister, and we saw the huge hail just pinging off the cement. Over top of our neighbor's roof, we just saw a huge funnel cloud starting, and I just ran and got everybody inside. And
I looked over at the trampoline, and I saw it blow away into that window, and the window cracked, and then it came back, and then it hit the siding. And it was terrible. I didn't like seeing my trampoline go flying everywhere.
The trampoline was swept hundreds of yards away. Only a few poles are left in the yard, along with debris from many of their neighbors' homes. Jason Dilley and his wife Felicia bought this, their first home, in January. They spent 2 months fixing it up. The storm ripped it in half.
Complete devastation, really, but I mean, the main thing is nobody was home in the house, and that's the important thing, that nobody got hurt in here.
It's quite a story to tell your children someday. You know, to say that, you know, our first house we didn't even get a chance to move in, and tornado took it away.
And the Red Cross and Salvation Army are lending a hand.
Did you get something warm to eat?
Yeah, we got good stuff.
Okay, looks like you have sweatshirts on, so you're staying warm.
Yeah.
They survived the tornado, but the storm is far from over.
As long as we have our family, we're all right.
And would you believe many of these families only had 30 minutes to get inside and grab everything they could before building inspectors put up this caution tape, calling some of these homes too dangerous for anyone to be in them. In the Fort Allen neighborhood of Hempfield Township, Westmoreland County, I'm Jennifer Mealy, Channel 4 Action News.
Just incredible tonight, the damage stretching all the way from Fort Allen to Sewickley Township. Look at this. Rooftops blown off, homes just ripped open. And that is just the start, as today marks day one of a massive recovery that may take months.
Picture your home gone, all your belongings destroyed. Picture reality for Dolores Marchalovich.
There's nothing in there I could salvage, nothing, not a thing. Everything is totally destroyed.
Her Fort Allen home is now this. Just a few pair of clothes, pictures from the past, that's it.
Just pictures that my grandma wanted because my grandfather had passed away in this house.
Homes ripped in half. Look at this, Sewickley Township's General Braddock Road, just a valley of destruction.
You can see there's nothing left of the trees. Those trees I planted, they were as big as my thumb when I planted them.
Trees on their sides, roof after roof ripped away, and now a new fear of scavengers actually stealing from the wreckage.
The best comes out in people, and the worst comes out in people. They're already stealing from these people on this street.
And those thankful for what they still have.
I was fortunate it missed us. Two blocks away, and there's homes ripped in half.
Nobody got hurt. It's all that God was watching over, because nobody got hurt.
So incredible. For the first time, we're getting a look inside this tornado. The National Weather Service confirming it was an EF2 with winds up to 120 miles per hour. 120. The path of destruction beginning in Rilton, stretching 7 miles. Incredibly, as you've heard, not one single person was hurt. We have so much more ahead, including a view from a first responder who arrived minutes after the tornado touchdown. A look at his video and the view from above. Traffic Watch 4's Scott Stiller takes you for a tour through the worst wreckage. Those incredible images now just minutes away. And remember to wake up right here on Channel 4 Action News this morning, starting at 4:30 a.m. We'll have the latest on the damage, the cleanup, and the push to declare the area a disaster zone.